Hello, my dear students. I am going to solve questions of exercise 2A. In this exercise, I will not be using the formula. In the next exercise, 2B, I will be using the formula. Let us consider question number 3. In question number 3, the principal is 2,800. The rate of interest is 10% per annum. And time is 1 whole 1/2 years. 1 whole 1/2 years. We have to calculate the compound interest. So for the first year means a duration of 1 year. The principal P at the beginning of the year is 2,800 rupees. Now the interest on it we can calculate by the formula P into R into T upon 100. Now, as I said, first year means a duration of 1 year. Therefore, the interest of first year we can find out by P into R, which is 10 into 1 upon 100. On simplification, it comes as 280 rupees. So 280 rupees is the interest of first year. This interest can be called as simple interest also. Now, we will add this principal and compound interest to get the amount at the end of the year, first year. 2,800 plus 280, which comes as 3,080 rupees. So, as I said in the last class that the amount at the end of year becomes the principal for the next year. So, that's why this 3,080, which is amount at the end of 1 year, becomes principal for the next half year. Since the duration is 1 whole 1/2 year, therefore I have written here next half year. So principal is 3,000. And this principal, the interest will be calculated using the same concept, P into R into T. But here, T we will consider as half, because the duration is half. So 3,080 into 10 into 1/2 upon 100, which comes as 154. So 154 rupees is the compound interest in half year, 280 is the compound interest in 1 year. Therefore, the compound interest in 1 whole 1/2 years we can find by adding these two interest, 280 plus 154, which comes as 434. So 434 rupees is the compound interest. Now, another question. Question number 5. In this question, we have 2480. 20,480 rupees as the principal. Rate is 6 whole 1/4% per annum. And the time is 2 years 73 days. So since the interest is, rate of interest is payable here in percentage per annum, therefore we need to change this 73 days to year. How we do? To change this 73 days into year, we need to divide 73 by 365. 73 is the factor of 365. It can cancel. If we read the table up to 5, So we get 2 whole 1 by 5 years as the duration. Now we want to calculate the compound interest in 2 whole 1 by 5 years. Let us calculate year by year. For first year, the principal is 20,480. Interest is 20,480 into, when we change this, it comes as 25 by 4. 25 by 4 into 1 upon 100. I have written here first year, that's why here T will be 1, not 2 over 1 by 5. On simplification, it comes as 1,280. Therefore, amount at the end of first year will be 20,480 plus 1,280.
20,480 plus 1,280,
21,760.
Now,
this amount becomes principal for second year. 21,760. Interest, 21,760. Into rate, into time, second year is the duration of 1 year, upon 100, 25,400.
So, compound interest for second year comes as 1,360.
So, the compound interest for first year is 1,280. Compound interest for second year is 1,360. Now, the time is 2 whole 1 by 5. So, we will write for the last 1 by 5 year. The principal will be the sum of 21,760 plus 1,360.
Which comes as 23,120. So this 23,120 is the principal for the last 1 by 5 years.
Let us calculate the interest. So, interest is equal to 23,120 into rate into time, time is 1 by 5 upon 100, 25,400. So when we simplify,
we get the compound interest in last 1 by 5 years as 289 rupees.
289 rupees. So, I have put the box.
So, this is the interest in 1 by 5 year, this is the interest of first year, this is the interest of second year. Therefore, the total interest means the interest in 2 whole 1 by 5 years
can be calculated by summing up these three interests, 1,280, 1,360, and 289.
1,280 plus 1,360 plus 289, which comes as 2,929. Therefore, the compound interest in 2 whole 1 by 5 years on 20,480 rupees is 2929. Thank you.